grandmother always said, people are like coffee. Add a pinch of sugar and you've got the makings of a masterpiece. Now, I know it seems strange to compare people to coffee, but my grandmother, she doesn't see it that way. To her, people are the coffee, and their positive outlooks and contributions are the sugar. Today, I will be informing my audience about the positive influence that my grandmother has had in my life. From my childhood with her, from her contributions to Thanksgiving and her huge dinners, and from the summer when she was diagnosed with a rare illness. From playtime to nap time, we spend as much time as possible together. Today, I will tell you a little bit about my childhood, and I really hope that it will have an influence on your life. My grandmother is one of the most positive influences in my life and has made me the person that I am today. Ever since I can remember, my grandmother has always been there at my side. From age 4 to now, she has always been there. When I was young, I spent almost all my time with her, and most of the time, it was just the two of us when my grandpa was farming out in the field. We were two peas in a small pod. Most kids share a special bond with their mother, but not me. I was a grandma's girl. She was my best friend, my mentor, and my teacher, all in one. And she never failed to make me smile or laugh. During my childhood, we would play Barbies, go camping, and watch family movies together around the holidays, Hallmark being our favorite channel. There wasn't a day that we weren't together, rain or snow, sleet or shine. My mother always thought that everyone needed a good influence in their life to anchor them down. For me, that influence was my grandmother, and I couldn't have been more happy. I will always cherish my childhood because of her. Her kindness and her consistent pestering me to be the strongest I can be really stuck with me over only 16 years of age. Now, sure, the memories were great, but Thanksgiving was the most influential on my childhood. Now, I know it seems odd since Thanksgiving isn't as extravagant as Christmas or Halloween, and it doesn't have a lot of movies about it, but Thanksgiving was always the holiday that I really enjoyed. During this time of year, my grandmother would always make a huge dinner, and everybody would show up. She made it her mission to have every single one of her 7 children there. It didn't matter if they were busy or if they had other things to do. They always came because she brought them all together, and it meant so much to her to have them all there. My grandfather always sat at the head of the table, whereas my grandmother sat at the other end of the table, and the rest of the guests filled up the rest. Talk consisted of my grandpa rambling on and on about a ripple in politics, and us girls didn't really pay much attention to it. So we would sit in the back and just talk about our own conversational, like how our lives are doing, and current interests that we all share. Every year, she would make her mother's secret recipe for carrot jello. Now, before you think it sounds gross, you should actually know that it's actually quite delicious. And it is one of my favorites. Now, I've explained the happy, and now I must explain the tragedy that struck during the summer when my grandmother fell ill and was hospitalized. On July 11, 2017, my grandmother was admitted to Midland Hospital. She had bleeding in her throat, and the doctors weren't very sure if she was going to make it. They diagnosed her with a rare case of cirrhosis of the liver, meaning that they didn't know the origin of the illness. My father and I rushed over as soon as possible, and when we got there, she was okay, but she looked very ill. Her skin was very white, and ice cold. She had bags under her eyes, and she looked gravely ill, and it made me worry. As time progressed during her 2-week in the hospital period, she began to gradually get better. So for the next 2 weeks or so, I would visit her every other day, and I would take care of her and do small tasks for her, such as retrieving her socks for her, fixing her blankets, and holding her mirror when she decided she wanted to wear makeup. Of course, she never asked me to do any of these things. I simply did them because she is and was my favorite person on earth. She gave me strength, so I did the same for her, being the anchor that she needed when the endless days were too much to handle. My grandma is one of the most positive influences in my life and has made me the person that I am today. She has shown strength when everyone around her was weak. Empathy when I needed someone who could understand. And I do not think that I will ever meet someone as inspiring as my grandmother. Someone who perseveres when they know that giving up just isn't an option anymore. Someone who has been through enough to see and feel that strength within, and I will remember her long after she is gone. Today, I have given you all a little insight to my childhood and what life was like growing up with my grandmother. I explained what Thanksgiving was like and her delicious home-cooked recipes, and finally, I expressed my feelings on what it was like taking care of her over the summer. My grandmother is only human, but to me, she is so much more. I will leave you with a quote from Leo Tzu: being deeply loved by someone gives you strength, while loving someone deeply gives you courage. Loving my grandmother deeply has given me strength, while loving her deeply has given me courage.